We have Brian Moss on the line from Rivals.com. Brian's the publisher for Tiger Sports Report. Thanks for taking the time to talk to us today, Brian.
Hey, no problem.
First off, the Tigers sitting at 2-1 so far, only loss coming to a very good Pac-12 team in UCLA. Tigers almost stealing that one from the Bruins. What can you tell fans about the Tigers who haven't seen Memphis play yet?
They're an exciting team to watch. I know they don't have the fanfare because of their recent lack of success in many years, but Coach Fuente has got this team believing in themselves, and they're a good, exciting team to watch. They throw a lot at you on offense, and they're very aggressive on defense. So if fans, when they see them for the first time, they get excited about it because it's an exciting team to watch.
Memphis, they had a very young team last year. They lost a lot of close games. Do you think that has helped them improve this year?
It has, and it's been that way for a couple of years since Coach Fuente has been there. His very first year when he took over, they had a great year and had a couple of close losses. I mean, they had four wins, but also another three games, I believe they lost, 14 points or less, and they were in games. So it was, all that combined with, Coach Fuente's philosophy that he wants to, play hard. The mentality of, losing is not acceptable anymore. These players now have pride. They're not settling for playing close. They want to win.
We figured Memphis would play strong defense, but how exactly has the offense improved?
They've really just paid attention to detail. They got some experience. They haven't done anything different. The offense last year is the same as the offense this year. It's just that they know what's expected of them now. Last year, through three games, I think they were 95th overall in the nation. Through three games this year, they're 26th. So when you talk to Paxton Lynch, about his progress from last year, his completion percentage is up. He feels more comfortable. I mean, he'll tell you that. Last year, he really had to think about where the receivers are going to be. The blitz packages from the opposing players. Trying to read everything. Now he doesn't have to think about it. He knows it.
Justin Fuente, he seems really excited about his team. What have you seen from Coach Fuente over the last few years?
I think when he first got here, there was it may not have been what he thought it would be, as far as not necessarily facilities, but player-wise. The talent level was not as possibly not as what he expected. So he really had to teach the basics, the fundamentals. And now he doesn't have to do that because it's already in place. It's really, it's been nice progression. He's having more fun now. You'll see him on the field cracking a smile at the end of the game. You didn't see that the first 2 years, but now you see that.
Yeah, people have to be excited about Memphis. A big 2 weeks for the Tigers. What's it like there in town?
There's definitely an excitement. The fans here have been wanting to support, Memphis football for a long time, since, the D'Angelo Williams times when they were going to bowl games with Tommy West. They want a winner. Memphis fans are great. But they need something there. They don't want to go, to the games and see a lackluster effort. And there hasn't been any since Coach Fuente has taken over. So the excitement's there, and the attendance is just going to continue to grow. Because you'll see, fans there that you haven't seen in a while that just pretty much gave up on Memphis football, that will only go to Memphis basketball. But you're seeing those fans coming back in there because they see the effort on the field.
On the road at Ole Miss, what would you say are the keys for the Tigers this weekend?
The keys for them is really just continue playing your game. You can't think about, we're going against, a top 10 team or a top 15 team. Because they did that against UCLA. They don't be at awe that, it's a quote-unquote bigger team or a quote-unquote better team because they're talented enough. They're starting to believe in themselves. And you saw that against UCLA where they almost pulled that off. So, the keys for them is really you play your game, limit the mistakes, and you really have to get after them. You're going to be in a hostile environment, so I think it's important for them to score early and take the crowd out of the game.
Yeah, we're looking forward to seeing how the Tigers do against this Rebels team this weekend. Is there anything else that you think we have to know about this Memphis team?
Just that, from years past, these Tigers, especially this senior class, last year left a bad taste in their mouth, especially on defense. I mean, they were a top 15 team defense going into the last two games of the season, and they fell flat. And this year's senior class, they took that personal, that they want to be known as the senior class that turned this team around. And so the attitudes and the sense of responsibility for this senior class has just been amazing. So it's a good time not only to be a Memphis Tiger fan, but it's good to see this team play if you haven't seen them play yet.
All right. Thanks a lot, Brian.
I appreciate it.